today's video session, we are going to discuss about what are the entry control and exit control statements in Scala. But before moving ahead, let's understand what is exactly, what is the meaning of entry control and exit control. So entry control loop, the test condition is checked first. So it means when in terms of loops, we have for loop, we have while loop, we have do while loop. But in case of for and while loop, we first check the condition. Okay, that is what it is saying. The loop, the test condition is checked first, and if that condition is true, then the block of a statement will be executed. So if we look into this code, I is 1, and it will it will work till the number 10. Okay, and it will sum up all the numbers altogether. But as you can see, this statement will only be executed when this condition is true, when I is less than 10. In case of while loop also, as you can see, I is 1 and I is less than equal to 2, then execute these statements. So in case of entry control loop, the test statements, the test condition is checked first, and if the condition is true, then the block of statements will be executed. It means the entry control loop, there are two types. The for loop is also for loop, and the while loop, they both are called entry control loops. Okay, or these statements we can use inside these loops. But in case of exit control loop, it first executes the body, and then check the condition. And if we look at the structure of do while loop, as you can see, I equal to 1, and do it is saying that do it. Okay, do execute it and then check the condition. So in do while loop, first the statements for the first condition, for the first iteration, all these statements will be executed irrespective of whatsoever the condition is. So first the statements for first iteration, the statements will be executed, and for the second iteration, this condition will be checked. So the exit loop, exit control loop, first executes the body of the loop. Okay, first this statements will be executed for the first iteration, and then we'll check the condition at the last. Okay, so if somebody asks you what are entry control loops, you should answer them. A for loop is for loop, and while loop are entry control loops, because in for loops, if the condition is not, the given condition is not true, then the further blocks of code or the statements will never be executed. But in case of exit control loop, the condition will be checked at the last. So for at least first iteration, for the first iteration, all the statements we have written inside do loop, okay, inside do block, all the statements will shortly be executed. And then for the second iteration, the condition will be checked, then the do loop will be executed. So these are the major differences. If we look at the theoretical aspect, the entry control loop checks the condition first, and then body of the loop will be executed, whereas the exit control loop first executes the body of the loop and then check the condition at last, as you can see over here. Okay, the body of the loop may or may not be executed at all. This is true. I told you that if this condition is false, okay, if this condition is false, then your further statements will not be executed. But in case of do while loop, the body of the loop will be executed at least once, because the condition is checked at the last. As I told you that for the first iteration, all these statements will be executed, but for the second iteration, first the condition will be checked. Okay. For and while loop are the examples of entry control loop, and do while is just one loop, is the example of exit control loop. So this is about what is entry and control, exit loop, what are such loops. And if we come to discuss the code, as you can see, we have I have extended app, so I don't need to create a main method in this object. Okay, in this Scala there is a concept. We have taken two variables, okay, sum and I. We have created a for loop. we are printing the value of sum for for loop. The same we are doing for the while loop, and then the same we are doing for the do while loop. So we can see all entry and exit control loops, how they work actually. Okay, so if we use until in for loop, so I will start from 1 and it will go till 10, but not for the 10th iteration. So if we simply print I, it will be I'll start from 1, so it will be 1 to 9. Okay, in until, the last iteration will not be checked. It is actually I less than 10. Okay, if we use 2, then we can, the last iteration will also be checked. So if we add up 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, then the sum would be 45 for this. So if this sum would be 45, if we check this while loop, okay, the while loop, it is initialized, I is initialized at 1, I then till I is less than equal to 10, then keep executing these statements. This is the concept. So it, this loop will work for 10th iteration as well, this will not. So here the output will be it is the same logic I have written over here, except just one iteration, that it would also run for the 10th iteration. So 10 will be added into 45, so the answer of this would be 55. Okay, let's come to the do while function. We have again initialized sum as 0 and I equal to 1. This statement will be executed irrespective of this condition. Okay, so this is actually calculated for the second iteration. When we are sure that okay, this at least this code will be executed, we should put it into the do while loop. Okay, because if the condition is false in both of these loops, this code will not be executed. So when you are sure that this code will always be executed for first iteration, then you should go with the do loop. The output of this loop will be, as you can see, we are adding up I into sum, and we are increasing I for every do statement, and it is less than equal to 10, so we are adding up 1 into all the rest of the digits. So the answer for this would be 45. Let's check this. Program name is Scala. Scala C is actually directly executing. For that, the objective exit in control, so Scala. So for loop, it is printing till 45. For while loop, it is printing till 55. I told you it will also work last iteration. For do while, it is printing 45. Okay, because it is less than equal to 10, so it would also work till last iteration. So for, we are adding 1 till next. See, this is 1. Okay, this is over here 1. Sum is 0 for the next. The sum for the, we are adding sum with the 1, so I would become 2. This is 1 and 2. So it will start like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 till 10. So till will also be added into that. So if we add up first 10 numbers, then the output would be 55. But if we add up first 9 numbers like this, okay, then the output would be 45. So this is all for today's lecture. So in today's lecture, we have discussed what is entry control and exit control loops. Okay, what are such loops, and for loop would come into entry control loop, and while loop also come into entry control loop, and the do while loop is the only loop that we call as an exit control loop, because the condition in such loop will always be executed for the second iteration, not for the first iteration. Whatsoever you write in do while loop will always be executed irrespective of whatsoever the condition is. So this is all for today's lecture, and thank you so much.